Gauss law. The title of this chapter. Okay, we have seen in the previous video the result of the Faraday's experiment that if you have two concentric spheres and the inner sphere was charged with a charge Q, so the inner sphere will make flux displacement, electric flux displacement to the outer sphere, and this electric flux displacement would equal the total charge on the inner sphere. Effectively, the experimental of Faraday was based on a spherical shape. However, Gauss has generalized this experimental, and he introduced that the electric flux passing through any imaginary closed surface, it shouldn't be a spherical surface, the electric flux passing through any imaginary closed surface is equal to the charge enclosed with that imaginary closed surface. So effectively, the experimental of Faraday, the enclosed charge was the charge on the inner sphere, and the closed surface was the outer sphere. So effectively, the electric flux passing through the outer sphere was equal to the charge on the inner sphere. But in general, it shouldn't be a spherical outer sphere. It can be any other shape. So Gauss law says that the electric flux passing through any closed surface is equal to the total charge enclosed by the surface. As an example, if we have arbitrary surface like this, but this surface is closed, so it is something like a bubble, for example, and inside this closed surface, or the volume of this closed surface including charge Q, so the total flux passing through this closed surface would equal the charge included by this closed surface. So mathematically, we can say that the incremental value delta epsi, which is the flux crossing delta S, would equal the flux density at delta S multiplied by delta S. But here we have to get the normal value of the flux density. So this is dot product. So we are going to say that the flux crossing delta S equal the flux density normal to delta S multiplied by delta S. Imagine that this is a window, for example, and this is a light. If the light is normal to the window, all the light will going across the window. If the light is parallel to the window, there is no light is going from the window. If the light is tilted with respect to the window, we are going to take the normal component of the light to the window, and this would be the corresponding part which is coming through this window, but the parallel part is not passing through the window. So we are interested only on the normal component of the electric flux density. Alright? So the flux crossing delta S is the normal component of the electric flux density, dS normal, multiplied by dS. And as we say that dS normal, effectively dS cosine theta. So we can say that if we have a unit vector A normal, which is normal to the incremental surface delta S, we can represent this in vector product as dS dot product delta S. dS is the vector of electric flux density, and delta S is the vector of the surface. And the vector of the surface is the surface with a vector normal to the surface itself. So the flux crossing incremental delta S, or the incremental flux crossing incremental delta S, is ds dot delta S. Alright? Now, the total flux would be the integration of this incremental flux. So, the total flux psi would be the integration of delta psi, which is the integration over this closed surface d dot ds. So, in other words, we say that the total flux would equal the integration over a closed surface, and take care this closed surface integration. It is not direct surface integration. The surface should be closed surface. So, the integration of a closed surface ds dot ds. Ds here is the electric flux density. Ds here is the incremental surface area. And this dot product. Alright? According to Gauss' law, the total flux should equal the charge enclosed. So, the total flux would be the charge enclosed. So, the integration over a closed surface ds dot ds, or in other words, the integration of a closed surface of the electric flux density dot the area, and this integration on a closed surface would equal the charge included inside this closed area. This effectively the integral form of Gauss' law. The integration over a closed surface for the flux density dot product with d area equal the charge included inside this closed surface. This charge can be discrete voltage charges. So, simply it can be the summation of discrete voltage charges. It can be volume charge. So, it can be rho V dV. Where dV here, it should be included inside the closed surface. It should not be the complete volume. Maybe it says just a part of the complete volume. But in general, it is the integration of rho v dv on the volume of the charge density inside the closed surface. It can be rho surface dA surface. It can be rho l dl. So it can be linear charge distribution density, or surface charge distribution density, or volume charge distribution density. In any case, the integration over a closed surface ds to ds would be the total charge included inside this closed surface. Okay? So, generally speaking, if we are talking about volume charge density, because any other charge distribution can be represented from volume charge density, so the integration over closed surface ds to ds, or electric flux density dot the surface, would equal the integration over the volume rho v dv. Rho v is the volume charge density and dv is the volume. Alright? So, this is Gauss' law in integral form. Let us apply this Gauss law in the problem of the Faraday. The problem of Faraday, we had an inner sphere of radius A, and this inner sphere was charged with charge Q. And according to the experimental of Faraday, the electric flux density was Q over 4 by R squared in the direction of R. Now, if you are going to talk about Gauss law, we say that the charge, the electric flux density at the inner surface A is Q over 4 by A squared in the direction of R. Right? So this is the electric flux density at the inner sphere. Assume that we have hypothetical Gaussian surface as a sphere, and this sphere is exactly the same radius A. So we can say that the integration of ds over this hypothetical surface should be the value of the charge inside this surface, which is Q. That's what we have seen in Gauss law. So we already have the electric flux density. We want to find out if this electric flux density over the closed surface would be this charge or not. So we can say that, okay, the surface area, the surface of a hypothetical surface around this sphere of radius A, ds would be the radius, which is A in our case, the radius A squared sine theta d theta d phi, and the unit vector in normal to this surface in the r direction. If you don't remember how to find this, please refer to chapter 1, part 3 or part 4, I can't remember, which is related to the spherical coordinates, how to introduce incremental surface in spherical coordinates. Okay? Alright, so this ds. Now, according to Gauss law, the electric flux density ds dot the area ds, ds dot ds, would be this value in r direction and this value in r direction. So is Q over 4 by a squared multiplied by a squared sine theta d theta d phi, and we have ar dot ar, so unit vector in its direction, it would be 1. So this one. Okay, this a squared can be replaced with this a squared, so d dot ds would be Q over 4 by sine theta d theta d phi. Now if you are going to make integration of d dot ds over a closed surface, the closed surface of this hypothetical surface around radius A is going from theta from 0 to pi, and phi from 0 to 2 pi. So we are talking about the circumference of the outer surface. So the integration over a closed surface ds to ds would be the integration of this integrand over theta coming from 0 to pi, this should be 0 to pi, and phi from 0 to 2 pi, this is 0, not phi. Okay, so making this integration, the integration of sine is minus cosine, and the limit of integration from 0 to pi, and the integration of phi, phi here is constant, so it would be phi. Okay, the integration of cosine, minus cosine from 0 to pi, it would be 2, because cosine pi is minus 1, so minus 1 minus 1 would be 1, and cosine 0 is 1, so this is 2. You can calculate it. So by calculating, so Q over 2 pi d phi, integration with respect to phi from 0 to 2 pi, so phi here is constant, so it would be phi from 0 to 2 pi, it would be 2 pi, 2 pi with 2 pi, it would be Q. So the integration over a closed surface ds to ds equal the charge included inside this surface, which is Q. Maybe someone says that you have proved that water is water. Effectively, this is a very simple example just to prove the idea of Gauss law. But in more complicated problem like infinite line charge, infinite surface charge, and other complicated configuration, we will see what is the advantage of using Gauss law. So this is just a proof that Gauss law is working right. Okay, so be patient and wait to see how we can make use of Gauss law in other complicated structures. All right, okay, see you in applications of Gauss law in other complicated structure in the next videos.